this is Brian Rowe with Mythic MTG Tech, looking at a magic tattoo that I got recently for Stasis. First, I want to start by saying a big thank you to everybody who contributed towards this tattoo. My birthday was in early April. I asked for no presents, please, but if anybody wanted to throw in cash, it would all go towards a magic tattoo, and I was able to afford a rather amazing magic tattoo done by Scott Falbo here at Arcanum Studios. It's based off of the card Stasis, and that's where we're really going to go first, is a little bit about this card. It's very unique in two different ways. Number one, it is an old school control card of the type you will never see again in Magic. It shuts down both players' untap phase. And it can be a little bit miserable to play against. When I was younger, I was not the nicest of players. I wanted to win any way possible. And that occasionally meant grinding a game out where I had drawn less cards than my opponent and watched my opponent deck themselves. Stasis shuts games down. It's a very, very grindy card. It's an interesting build-around card. It attacks on an entirely different axis than most anything else in Magic by trying to lock the game down and keep it in that particular state. The other thing that makes this so interesting is that this was before Magic had art direction. Artists were hired and just given the name of a card and asked to create something. And Stasis is definitely one of the most original, weird, unusual pieces of artwork in all of the Alpha and Beta set, if not all of Magic's history. It was done by Faye Jones. I'm going to talk about her a little bit later. Let's dive into a few decks related to Stasis, though. Stasis started off very strong in competitive Magic. This is 1996 Worlds held in Seattle. This is Standard, although as you'll notice, Standard was a little bit different back then. They had a restricted list for Standard. So it was the most recent cards and a group of one-ofs as part of it. This deck finished in the top eight at Worlds. It's a hardcore control deck. It has Kismet so that things come into play tapped. It's got Balance, which is one of the most broken cards ever printed. It has ways to regrow with Recall. Very strong three-color control deck here. Limdol's Vault is also another nice one. Helling Mines are in here. This is a fun control deck, and actually the artist who did the Stasis rendition for me for the tattoo actually played Turbo Stasis back in the day. This is a old school Stasis deck. This is probably the most beautiful Stasis deck that I could find online. It's by Danny Friedman over at Eternal Central. Just an incredible old deck. It's got your components of control there. It's got Time Elemental, which I'm going to go into a little bit later. It's got your Time Vault there as an option. Really interesting deck overall. Stasis can be played in Modern Legacy. Saffron Olive played this deck recently for one of his challenges and went 50-50 on it. What I really like about this deck is the new addition of Raul Zarek as tech. I believe that this deck may actually be able to be tweaked into a solid tier 2 Legacy deck. The biggest problem with Stasis right now in competitive Legacy is that Abrupt Decay is a card, and it's really tough to deal with for Stasis. Outside of Abrupt Decay, you've actually got some pretty good matchups out there. It attacks on a different axis, and it has so many aspects of control in it. You can stop a lot of combo decks really early and then take over the game. One of the other things that I really like about Stasis is that I played it in a deck with Time Elementals. Time Elemental, as many of the older fans here will know, was the icon that I used for my channel before I created a little logo there that's up in the left-hand corner. Actually, it was the Sarah Angel Time Elemental misprint that was up there in the corner, one of my favorite cards. I actually played the misprinted Time Elementals and regular Time Elementals in that competitive deck when I was much, much younger. Judges were aware of it. It was a much more relaxed time around misprints. You explained it to people and you had the regular versions of the card available. It wasn't about tricking somebody, it was about showing off these really rare, cool old cards. Time Elemental is still one of my favorite things you can do with Stasis. You can return it to your hand every turn so that the Stasis doesn't affect you, it only affects your opponent. Talking a little bit more about the artwork, this is one of the few Magic pieces of artwork from the Alpha and Beta set that was from a very well-respected artist in the community, even outside of Magic the Gathering. There are some other well-known artists in Magic the Gathering, kind of the fantasy genre, but Faye Jones was an extremely popular, or I should say is an extremely popular artist here in the Seattle area. As you wander around Seattle, you will see some of her work up at University of Washington in the transit tunnels. It's also featured in some prominent museums throughout the Northwest. She is actually the aunt of Richard Garfield, the creator of Magic the Gathering, and did this card kind of as a favor to Richard as he was creating the game. So it's interesting to see this artist, who has a really long, rich history of art, creating and contributing a very original card to the Alpha and Beta set. There's a link down in the description of a biography done of her over on Vimeo that has almost 100 pieces of her artwork in it. It's fascinating. I definitely recommend taking a look at it if you want to know more about Faye Jones. The other artist that really contributed to this tattoo and did all of the work on it, this is Scott Falbo. He is over at Arcanum Studios here in Seattle in the Fremont area. Used to be with Apocalypse on Capitol Hill, and I originally ran into his work because one of his business cards was actually kind of an alpha cut Magic card that he had custom made back for that old Apocalypse studio. I wish I had a copy of that to share with you. If I'm able to find that, I'll throw it up on Instagram or share it more broadly. But Scott is a wonderful tattoo artist, well-respected in the Seattle area, and does some of the coolest, geekiest tattoos out there. He's a geek and a Magic player himself. This is just to highlight a few of the pieces of artwork that he has done. He can do pretty much anything, and he has a lot of creativity in the work that he puts forward. I especially like some of his 8-bit artwork. It really looks like the video game is coming to life on your skin. He has some amazing pieces also that are hand pieces. If you're going to get a tattoo done on your hand, you want to make sure that it is of the highest quality possible. And Scott is one of those people that I would trust to do a hand tattoo. All of his hand pieces that I've seen just look amazing. They add another dimension and often let you look like you're peering into someone with them. Scott has an Instagram that is well worth following. He posts some of his designs as he comes up with them there and asks if there's anybody in the community who's interested in them for tattoos. I've seen several pieces also based off of Miyazaki, which is another one of my absolute favorite cultural influences. So I'm going to have future work done by Scott. Who knows, I may even turn this left arm into a sleeve that is dedicated to Magic, and my right arm has something related to Japanese cinema. I wouldn't mind doing some Miyazaki on that side, but I definitely recommend following Scott over on Instagram. You'll just see some amazing stuff come forward. The rest of this video is going to be a little bit light on narration. I'm going to throw a song over it and let you see the process of this coming to life. This is the sketch that Scott did, and one of the things that I really like about it is up there at the top, he added a reference to the blue mana symbol in the moon. So he really added this additional geek element that is just beautiful in it. I'm super happy with the way this has turned out. So this is the final tattoo. It's almost done healing here. I'm super happy with it. That is a beta stasis that I picked up over at Guardian Games the other day while I was down in Portland. The individual behind the counter actually noticed the stasis tattoo and then worked with me to give me an amazing deal on a beta stasis. That's a version that I do not have in my collection. In fact, I didn't have any black border stasises, so super happy to have that added. A few questions that people have come up and asked me about with regards to the tattoo. Did it hurt? Yes, but it's well worth it. How long did it take? We're looking at about three and a half, a little bit less than 4 hours. It was done in a single session. Am I going to do more magic related tattoos? And I'm thinking about it really seriously. I'm thinking about making it something annual to work on developing a sleeve here on the left hand side. Magic is a huge part of my life and I've really enjoyed putting together this channel. So I want to give a big shout out also to Michael Moore, who came in and took those photos for me. And if you want more content around Magic the Gathering, subscribe to the channel. Thank you to everybody who's over there on Patreon supporting the channel. I greatly appreciate it. It means a lot to me. I'm working on the Eternal Masters estimated value video coming out later this week, along with some top 10 lists related to Eternal Masters. Take care, and until next time, choose the cards wisely.